Haiti is the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere and routinely ranks in the bottom 5% in almost every category you look at.
The resurgence of dengue fever virus worldwide is principally due to the development of resistance to normal control practices for mosquitoes.
As citizens of a country that is blessed with virtually unlimited opportunity, it is sometimes difficult to grasp the fact that in Asian, African, and Latin American countries, over 500 million people are living in absolute poverty. 98% of all childhood deaths are in third world countries. And millions of people die every year from diseases that are treatable and in many cases, preventable. While some claim that our opportunities and freedoms blind us to the plagues that torment the poorest in the world, these gifts are also the mechanisms by which we are able to dream of a world without disease, to address the global health crisis, and to pursue global solutions for the world's most vulnerable people.
What you got to remember is that the major diseases that are the issues in global health are diseases that don't kill Americans. There is this sort of hope that those of us who work on these things can somehow make a difference.
The fact that those who have chosen to stand against diseases which pose little or no personal threat is indicative of a mission that is driven by more than self-preservation.
These diseases that we're seeking to address, malaria, for instance, dengue fever virus, are diseases that happen to people in very poor and underdeveloped countries. And that's another reason why they're difficult to control, is because the countries do not have the resources.
Since its founding, the mission of the University of Notre Dame has been one of service, grounded in faith, and guided by a vision of what is possible when people of faith work together to help solve the world's problems by educating and inspiring people to action.
Welcome to the Jordan Hall of Science, a building that is as beautiful as it is rich in educational resources. Science has a tremendous history at the University of Notre Dame. And with the opening of this building, it takes a great step forward to educate our students in science for the 21st century. We're very excited about the future of science at the University of Notre Dame.
Notre Dame has a distinctive mission within higher education. We foster not only an intense passion for the intellectual pursuits, but also with great attention to the faith and to the heart.
This is an opportunity for the university to say to the world, science should be at the service of the poor.
The commitment of Notre Dame, faculty, staff, and students, although a driving force in the effort to understand and eliminate disease, is not enough. It's only by combining the vision of researchers with the supporting resources of those who share the vision of global health that diseases such as malaria, dengue fever, and yellow fever will be eradicated.
My research is trying to find a means to make a mosquito that cannot transmit malaria anymore, and to take advantage of our genetic understanding of the mosquito to make it that way.
The most important part of our program in Haiti is to eliminate the disease lymphatic filariasis. There's about 1.5 million people infected with a parasite in Haiti and 120 million people around the world.
We are also interested in developing new classes of antibacterials.
I can't think of anything that's more satisfying as an occupation than saving lives. And just the thought of, if I can work on this one, what about other diseases? It's exhilarating.
The University of Notre Dame's mission of service took a leap forward because of the generosity of benefactors who made it possible to construct the Jordan Hall of Science, a state-of-the-art science learning center. Designed with the latest digital technology and most advanced educational techniques. The world will reap the benefits of the generosity of those who shared the vision.
Really, science is a way of knowing. It's a way of exploring how things behave by making observations and by tying together phenomena in ways that give us understanding and predictability. And students experience that most authentically when they're making those observations and they're making those inferences. And we can offer that in a laboratory setting in a way that we could never do in a lecture setting. So by having the capacity in this building of 40 separate types of specialized labs, we create experiences for students that really engage them in what it means to be a scientist, not to just be a consumer of scientific information.
Jordan Hall is built on the idea of active rather than passive learning. So the idea is learning by doing. That's an easier way to learn. That's going to prepare these students for the next generation of scientific breakthroughs. We value scientific inquiry at this university.
It's exciting to see this building finally come into existence. We've been thinking about this building for decades, planning it for the last 5 years, and now to see it as a reality is truly exciting. The opportunities that lie ahead are tremendous.
The impact that Jordan Hall bodes for global health is incalculable in that its true value will only be known in retrospect, as the world's diseases are addressed by the scientists in training that pass through its doors.
There is tremendous synergy between the research efforts at the university and opportunities for undergraduates to engage in a more full educational experience. And what Jordan does is it prepares our students in ways they have not been prepared in the past on what are the state-of-the-art techniques used in research labs so that they can immediately transfer that information, that skill, into tackling problems that are confronting the world today.
We recruit very, very good students. This is an opportunity for all of them to be in a very quality environment in terms of research and education. And quite frankly, the only thing that limits them is the amount of passion that they bring to their own work.
Passion is something that can't be taught. However, what we can do is we can prepare your mind and we can give you the skills that can make those dreams come true.
The Jordan Hall of Science will provide future scientists with the tools they need to understand disease, to explore solutions, and to forge the future of science. The generosity of those few, with the commitment of many, promises a world that will be forever changed for the better.
Is trying to figure out how to solve some of these problems an important thing for a university like Notre Dame to do? Absolutely. It's consistent with the care and concern for the poor of the world that really need the care and concern of those of us who have resources.
The College of Science is extremely proud and excited about the opening of the Jordan Hall of Science. It represents a huge commitment on the part of the administration of the university, the trustees, and the benefactors. We will all be indebted to these people for decades to come. We're very proud of it. We're going to use this building in every way we can to enhance the education of our students at Notre Dame. We think it's a mission that is appropriate for a Catholic university like the University of Notre Dame, and we want it to be a premier university in every sense of the word.
Thank you.